Alright, you guys, so we are headed over to ITC Gardenia. Rowan behind me is carrying all the camera luggage here. So we are going to just shoot a few videos there, talk to a few key Shopify team people, and let's have some fun. So I'm inside ITC Gardenia. Welcome to the Garden City, Bangalore, and ITC Gardenia. So this is basically one of my favorite hotels here in Bangalore. I've stayed here a few times, love it. And this is exactly where they're hosting the Shopify Pursuit event. So glad they are. So we're going to get inside now. We're going to talk to a few key people here and we'll share all the juicy tidbits with you guys. So many flowers. Alright, you guys, I'm here with Shashank from Push Owl. Just check this out. So this is an awesome guy here. Known him for a few months now. And what I'm going to do is ask him one question. Alright, this is a one question lightning round for him. So basically, he's the founder of Push Owl. Push Owl is a push notification service. And it's actually been growing like crazy. So Shashank, the question to you is, like, what is one key way in which Push Owl has actually helped merchants scale their business to like new levels? Like, you have got, I believe, things like automated sending based on abandoned carts and all. So what has been the key metric that your merchants follow in order to get revenue boost from their business?
So the best way push notifications help you is actually helps you connect with your customers, right? Think of it as a channel. It's a communication channel between you and your customers, right? And we just added a new medium to it. Just like emails, SMS, or ads were, right? But it's kind of free and it's instant. So the moment you send one push notification, you instantly connect to your thousands of subscribers. So that helps you, right? And you, the metric which you're gonna track is the number of people coming to your site and ultimately getting you sales, right?
So, yeah. So great catching up with you, Shashank. So I'm looking forward. So he's actually speaking. He's one of the main speakers at the Pursuit event. So I'll try to capture some footage of him speaking as well. Thanks, buddy.
Thank you.
So I've got Anshuman here with me. He's the Shopify sales lead and we're at the Pursuit event right now, open office hours. And I'm going to ask him some questions that you guys have been commenting on my channel so many times asking about. So this is like the official word of response from the Shopify team about those questions. It's going to help you guys, teach you guys how their mind works, how they can help you better launch your own business. Plus, it's going to be a few hard questions. And because, you know, you guys keep commenting on those questions, so I'm just going to dump it all onto Anshuman here. So Anshuman, thank you so much for giving me your time here. So I got these questions. First question, I don't even need to see my notes, is that, like, since we have a lot of audience from India and they are trying to open up their Shopify stores, selling abroad, like most of my audience right now wants to sell abroad in USD. So, and a lot of them are beginners. So the first thing that comes to mind, and this is a question I've gotten many, many times, is that a lot of credit and debit cards do not work. So most of my questions here are going to be like onboarding sort of issues that people face. So could you just shed some light on what kind of banks, what kind of credit and debit cards work? Because I know that you guys have done a special thing for India where you accept debit cards also, right? So just let me know a little bit about that.
I think your question is around the credit card that a customer swipes or a debit card that a merchant wants to apply on the store to pay his fee.
Merchant wants to apply on the store to pay the fee.
Okay. So debit cards with ICICI Bank and HDFC Bank, we've seen work with the Visa ones. And credit cards, any credit card works well. Just make sure that the credit card, and I'm sure that's not a case, it should not be a RuPay credit card, or any card that is RuPay will not work. All Visa, Master, Amex works very well. And debit cards, especially from ICICI Bank and HDFC Bank on Visa, work well. So we've seen that working for our merchants.
And do they need to be like international debit cards or like plain debit cards from
ICICI? Most of the cards that a bank offer are international debit cards, especially with ICICI Bank and HDFC Bank. Most of the problem arises with debit cards offered by the public sector banks, like the State Bank and SBI. So we feel that the banks that offer from especially ICICI and HDFC Bank, their cards work well.
And does Axis Bank also work well? That's also something that a lot of
I don't have an answer to Axis Bank, but I can check and get back to you.
All right. So, like, first thing you have to note is that ICICI, HDFC, just to summarize for you guys, ICICI, HDFC, so you can easily, because a lot of you guys have opened up your companies now, so now you can progress over to your current accounts opening up with ICICI or HDFC. They'll issue you a free international debit card. Just use it to, you know, pay for a Shopify
payments.
I have
one more suggestion. Yeah. So, I would suggest all these guys to put a small FD with, say, an ICICI bank.
Right.
An FD gives you a credit card against the FD. So, if you put an FD, say, or 30,000 rupees, right, ICICI bank will give you a credit card which is like 80% of the FD value.
Right.
And credit card makes a lot of sense for using it, because then you get time to clear your bills.
And credit cards, of course, any bank is going to work, because that just works.
But so, I still refer going for a MasterCard, either from HDFC or ICICI bank. MasterCard, for especially for international transaction, is much more safe and secure.
All right. So now let's move on to the next topic of discussion. Again, this is something that a lot of people have asked. And it's going to be about payment gateways. So apart from PayPal and to checkout, the other option is Stripe, right? So instead of like opening up Stripe Atlas, now I did read up on like Stripe is trying to come to India. You being like part of such a big team, and I know that you know, Stripe and Shopify has a connection. So do you have any like insider information on when Stripe is going to be publicly launched in India?
So Stripe started their beta last year, but right, they are still stuck with RBI regulations and configuring with a lot of net banking options. Mm. So it's minimum going to take another 6 months. Otherwise, there's no official announcements. We see minimum 6 months. But again, for most of the guys who are doing dropship business, don't have a GST number,
right,
from India. Because you don't need a GST number to do the dropship business.
You actually do. You do.
No.
So you do. So, you do need a GST number. I'll tell you why. So especially if you apply for a PayPal business account, so PayPal charges a currency conversion fee. So they take a GST. They apply to an input tax credit.
And then you get the benefit.
Right. So I do recommend. So this is something I've told over and over. In fact, when you are doing Facebook ads, so when you apply for GST
number. So they say that if you've done volume of above 30,000 USD on Facebook, you are entitled for INR and GST billing.
Right.
They just started from 1st of October. So for guys who feel challenged while running the store in the US, if you are using, if you are kind of getting in Chinese stuff to be sold in US and money is collecting, so money, technically you need the money back in India. Now the best way to do that, what I have seen, is one, apply for, try doing that from an Indian payment gateway which only gives you USD checkout.
Which ones are those?
CC Avenue is one of them, who gives you USD checkout. Mm. So if your store currency is on USD, CC Avenue will give you a USD checkout. But for that, CC Avenue will then ask you questions that where are the invoices?
Right.
Because you'll have problems against charge. Tomorrow if there's a chargeback and there's no invoice raised by your Indian company, then there's a problem. So technically, first of all, to get a CC Avenue payment gateway, you have to have a set business in India. Second, to have an international access from CC Avenue, your business should be at least 2 years old.
Oh, okay.
So that's another challenge. So all these guys who are coming in dropship business,
beginners
will not get an Indian payment gateway,
right,
because these are startups. If you can get some banking or some information where you show that it's a 2 years old business, CC Avenue will give you, so which needs a proper banking statements, proper GST returns being filed, tax returns being filed. If you can get all these things done, CC Avenue can give you a payment gateway with international acceptance and only USD being activated on your checkout page.
So that is awesome. So that this is some new information that has come to light right now. So now, regarding Stripe, let's get back. So 6 months is when we are like expecting, because see, when Stripe comes, all the problems are basically solved because of the integration you guys have with Stripe. Now when Stripe is launched, because I know they got a new round of funding also, especially for entering the Asia Pacific countries. So Stripe is coming. So when Stripe comes, will you also launch Shopify payments for Indian customers?
We do have plans, but honestly, I can't commit on any timelines as of now, because we are still, the dependency for this part would be on Stripes, and they're still struggling with RBI and other guidelines, so it will take some time.
Chalo, let's give it another 6 to 8 months and then we'll take forward the discussion. Now, I want to ask you like a favor. Now, this is for helping you guys. So, can we as a company, like, because a lot of people
because I deal with a lot of beginners who want to start their stores, even though I have my services, but still a lot of people prefer to do it on their own. For them, like 14 days is a slightly shorter period of time. Can we get like a 30-day kind of a trial working for some of my audience and a unique link for that or something?
If it's a genuine reason, my support team can extend the trial for 14 days.
So
they'll have to request the support team,
right,
logging into the chat or the email support.
Right. So that's actually pretty helpful for a lot of people then. You automatically do that without even needing to say anything. So 21 days is what happens to the extended trial. So I think that's good enough.
Plus 7.
Yeah, that's good enough to launch a store, I think. All right, so another quick question here. So this is something I wanted on my store also. Can we please get multi-currency checkout?
Okay. So with Shopify payments, multi-currency is already in beta phase.
Is it?
Yeah, so only offered to a very few merchants.
Okay.
We are still in the, as I said, it's still in beta phase, being offered to a very few plus merchants. Give us 6 months, it'll be launched all across Shopify payments.
Wow. Guys, this is going to be big. For all you guys who want to sell worldwide, if you have multi-currency enabled on your store, this is some new information coming right here, guys. Hit that like button. All right, so now, all right, so I want to just, we are on the final stretch of things. You've been very helpful. The final question is, any other common like onboarding issues that you've seen Indian merchants face, especially like Indian dropshippers who face while they're opening up their Shopify stores, that you've seen on your own and you want to shed some light on like this issue is there and what solutions are there for those issues?
During the festival days and where China has a lot of rush,
right,
and a lot of things, your packets are not delivered,
right,
and thereby your chargebacks increased.
Right.
Then I've seen a lot of customers writing that your product ships from US warehouse, which is technically not right to put it on your website.
Mm-hmm.
You should not be doing it. Rather, I would really suggest that we Indians have so much in India, so much products available, so much inventory available. We have figured out a couple of logistic problems and we know partners who can deliver your shipment from India to the US market in 7 to 10 days. Why not start something from India?
What are those? I want to know those.
Because
I can connect you.
Oh, that's going to be awesome.
So 7 to 10 days and the rates are starting from 100 grams. 100 grams, 200 grams, 300 grams, 400 grams. For a 100 gram packet, you won't even pay more than 250 rupees.
That's pretty low because you're selling in USD.
USD, yeah, correct. So any shipment that you send from India, anyways, you're putting a 2x factor on it on your pricing.
3x.
Minimum, yeah. So 3x factor. And even if you make it shipping free, it makes a lot of sense.
Profit.
If you look at couple of categories like tea,
right,
there's so many guys from India shipping out tea to global countries, and they're making hell lot of money.
Right. So I have the only problem I have with this is AliExpress. So the whole concept of dropshipping is around finding like unique,
correct,
never heard of products.
Products, yeah.
Right. So the people you're going to connect me with, like those Indian merchants, so 7 to 10 days people. So let's say I find a new product that's working for me. All right. So will they be importing in bulk and then sending over to the US, or will they already have it in stock? Because AliExpress has like millions of products, right? So I'm presuming that the Indian logistics partner does not have millions of products in their warehouse right now. So how do we deal with that? Like if there's a new brand new product on AliExpress that's just working, how do we get that logistics partner to import it to India and then ship it out?
Okay, so there are two ways to do it. I've seen customers, so first thing, I would say that find Indian products. Find a supplier in India and then do it. That's one way. Second approach, the products that you feel are working very well in the US, figure out a way, because Amazon provides you a service that you can put your SKUs in Amazon's warehouse in the US and they'll fulfill it through any channel that you do. That's second option. Third option, getting a product from China to India only makes sense if you're even selling it in India.
Right.
Then your cost gets optimized. From here, then you can find partners to do it there. The best part of doing this is that you do a legitimate business from India doing GST invoicing. You're never stuck in any of your exports. Government even gives you some benefits on your exports. You even get some cut on your export duties, or rather you make some money over there. So then you create a valuation for your business where you then become an Indian as well as an export merchant.
So there's a challenge that I've planned out that's going to be about selling in India by importing from abroad or using Indian suppliers.
So I would request you look at a couple of websites. There are one product websites and
right,
selling like crazy in India.
Right.
I have on Shopify Gold 15 such URLs, one product. Every 3 months, they'll change the URL, change business account.
Yeah.
Have a new product.
Are they selling from India?
From India, stocks from India, picking up. And I even have merchants, they will pick up small inventory, run their campaign for 3 days. If they see there is good volume, they'll hold their campaign for a week or place an order. The product gets delivered by air and then they run their campaigns. And I know pickup people selling fidget spinners in containers. I know a merchant who's sold over 10 containers of fidget spinners in India.
So they are selling in India?
In India.
Oh wow, there's
only
a big market in India.
There's a huge market in India.
You have to be just very price conscious.
Very price conscious, yeah.
So there's a lot of new things that I learned today. Interesting discussion.
Come on, yaar.
It's going to be fun.
Rather, it's learning from you.
Wow, you've taught a lot.